Hey guys, Dr. Ahmad Al-Hassiny here from the Institute of Digital Dentistry. Now, the Shining 3D Elite, their flagship scanner, has just been released. And one of the main features of this scanner is intraoral photogrammetry. So what I wanted to do in this video is show you how that actually works. I have a few models. Here's a all-on-4 and a all-on-X model. And so what we're going to do is test the whole workflow out and see how does this actually work. So over here, I've got the Shining 3D software. You start up the software and you create a new order. That's the first step. You put in the patient's name. I will just put in IDD test. The thing to do to get this all working is in the Shining 3D lab form, let's say, you need to click implant. And then you'll see at the bottom here, coded scan body. Each one of these high accuracy coded scan body kits that the company sends with the scanner has this little QR code and a barcode or a serial number. And then you put this into the software and now it's all connected. The software knows which specific kit you are using. And you just have to inform it which jaw you are going to scan. And in this case, we are going to do the lower jaw scan. The next thing to do is to choose the implants or denote on the software how many implants there are and the rough positions of them. So we're going to click over here, click over here, click over here, and click over here. So pretty stock standard all on four treatment there. And then there's a few other options that you have where you can scan a pre-op model. This is the case where let's say you have a prosthetic already made. However, we're not going to do that in this video. Instead, we're going to assume that these are immediate loading. So we've just placed the implants, we've put the multi-unit abutments, because take note, this system works on multi-unit abutments. It is not direct to fixture. And then we click scan. And it tells you, do you want to choose an implant system first? I will just pick the stock standard implant that I use quite commonly in my practice, which is Ostem, and add it to all applications. Because if there are multiple different implants, you can choose different implant systems. So the software is actually quite thought out. It's actually quite an intelligent workflow they've done. Now it says to wake up the scanner. I'm going to grab the scanner here. It is a simple USB-C connection and I will put it in here. What you will notice is instantly the scanner wakes up with a green light and then we can click scan. Right, so now it says scan guidance. The software shows you a bunch of little tips, how to, you know, get the scanner going, how to scan properly. We're gonna close these tips off. And what you see is a really interesting thing at the top there, because this is a brand new software workflow for full arch intraoral photogrammetry. And first things first, it tells you to scan the edentulous arch. On the bottom left, you've got a whole bunch of AI tools, intraoral, edentulous, etc., all on X, provisional denture scanning. These AI tools are critical. If you try scan a model, while it says intraoral, you're going to have a really hard time. I'm going to turn on intraoral and I'm going to start scanning here. And where we start is right at the back here, top of the implants, and you move forward and you take the scan. As you can see, the Shining Elite is a capable scanner. It's really what we've come to expect nowadays in the intraoral scanner market. I mean, if you can't scan fast in this market, you're doing something very wrong. Just like that, we have scanned the implants. Then what we do is we click this finish symbol and it takes us to the next step. It will tell us ending scan and this is the next step. This is one of the most exciting things and really the interesting thing about all of this. Shining 3D could have easily just launched some scan bodies and even these, some flat scan bodies and called it a day. But they've actually created a whole workflow here. So what you do in the mouth is now you have these implant positions, you have your multi-unit abutments. And here we have this high accuracy coded scan body kit. And what you can see is these are the different scan bodies you get. You get a torque wrench, some screwdrivers, and these scan bodies come in a whole bunch of different lengths. It's super interesting because anyone who's read up about full arch implant scanning knows that this is kind of where the industry is going towards. Rather than cylindrical scan bodies, we've got these flat low profile and long scan bodies. It just helps with maintaining accuracy. And what you're supposed to do is you take these scan bodies and you put them onto your multi-unit abutments. So let me do that. And the trick is you want them all to be facing towards the center of the mouth. And I'll show you what that looks like in a second once I screw them in. So you can screw them in. The company also gives you a torque wrench because I believe you're supposed to torque these up to about 5 Newton centimeters. Let me get another one here on the other side. I'm using 2 long ones. Anyone who's familiar with the Osteon Nexus IOS system will be sort of familiar with this workflow. It is quite similar. And how the workflow is that you put these special scan bodies in and they kind of create a bridge. You'll see what I mean in a second. The key is that the scan bodies do not touch. They shouldn't be touching each other. And I guess the main difference with the Shining 3D system here is instead of actually scanning these like scan bodies, if you see all these little dots, this is what the scanner is going to be capturing. So let me finish this up by putting the last 2 coated scan bodies here. And once again, the company does say you're supposed to torque these to a certain amount. And also the company recommends after doing this, taking an OPG and making sure these are sitting perfectly. Because the last thing you want is assuming that everything is sitting right, sending this to the lab to get made, and then having an ill-fitting restoration. Just like that. I hope you can see that. I'm sure we will zoom in. But this is the full arch with these special scan bodies in place. Now on the software, this is really where the magic happens. The next step is not to scan these like traditional scan bodies. What you actually do is scan the dots, and you'll see what the software is doing now on the screen. It's actually quite remarkable. It's totally ignoring the scan body. It's just seeing the dots. And then once it recognizes the dots enough, it will move the digital file or align the digital file of the specific scan body onto the arch. And the company says, you can see there's some orange dots, some green dots. The company says you basically want all the dots to be green and then you are done. This is me taking my time and just talking through the whole process. You can easily get this done, I would say, in about 20 to 30 seconds, no doubt. And now you have your implant positions almost relative to each other, or at least these coated scan body kits. And then you click the tick. Now, it doesn't just stop there, because that could have been it. We could have taken this off, but now you have the lower jaw, the edentulous scan, and you have the scan or position of these black coated scan body kits. Now it's how do you align this to the edentulous arch. And this is really where the magic happens and really what's amazing about what Shining 3D has done, because again, the workflow is just so slick and they've really thought it out. The last step is to scan the coated scan body kit and then align it with the edentulous arch. And how you do this is quite cool. If you watch the screen here, first you start on one of these coated scan body kits. And then you just start scanning and it will recognize the whole coated scan body kit and then it will align it. The next thing you do is roll down, and the software actually did it super fast. That was a bit too fast there, but you're supposed to roll down and then capture some of the edentulous ridge and it will align it all together. That is how it's supposed to work. And again, green shows you when it is recognizing that scan body. And it's seeing it and it's confirming to you on the screen that that has been scanned properly. What you can also see, so that is one of the splicings. You can then add multiple splicings. And what that basically means is that we scan the right-hand side. You can also scan the left-hand side. You'll see this again. We will start on the screw and then it will align everything together. Last thing you can do now is actually add more splicing. Once you did the 2 main ones, the software now goes to this database because it knows the digital library of these special coded scan body kits that Shining has done. And through the software, you can now choose the specific multi-unit. And so if we go through the database here, any implant of your choosing, And you can see all the implants that the company is currently supporting. And now you choose which one of these you have used. So if we match this here, and then you click finish. So what this is basically doing is doing all the alignment, all the matching of all the digital libraries in the software itself. It is really quite remarkable. And then you can click finish. And the last thing you do, as I mentioned, is if you wanted to, you can add another splicing area. Let's say the anterior. You start on top of the scan body and then you roll downwards and then it will align this. Once again, we can add whichever multi-unit it is. And that is it. So what we've done is we've scanned the edentulous arch, scanned the special high accuracy coded scan kit, and then through the software converted these into the multi-unit abutment. And this is all done within the Shining 3D software. If we click finish now, it will tell you that you should scan the top arch. We're just going to skip this for now. And I just want to show you the final. You can of course scan the bite. Let's click finish and just go to post-processing. And there it is. And this is the final output that you get from the software. So we've scanned the edentulous arch, we've scanned these high accuracy coded scan markers, and then the software gives you this. It's done all the digital conversion through the software, and this is what you can send to the lab. So honestly, quite a remarkable invention here and quite a remarkable innovation. The first of its kind in the entire intraoral scanner market. I'll be very curious to see how the market responds, how other scanner companies respond to this, and also the photogrammetry companies. But this is basically, in a nutshell, how you use the Shining 3D Elite scanner for full arch implant scans. I would love to hear your thoughts. Please leave a comment or a question below if you have any questions about this workflow. And of course, with these high accuracy coded scan kits, they are included with every single Shining 3D Elite scanner. The scanner sells for around $20,000 USD, and you get this kind of photogrammetry kit included. And for those of you who may be wondering, which implant system does this work for? The company is supporting all major implant systems, and they make a specific kit for different groupings of implants. I'm sure your Shining 3D rep can help guide you in that sense. So all you really need to tell them is which specific implant that you use mostly in your practice, and they will give you the right kit. And you can order extra kits if required. That's everything for this video, guys. Thanks for watching. And as always, to keep up to date with everything digital dentistry, go to instituteofdigitaldentistry.com. See you next time.